Hey guys, so today me and Carter here are going to test a physics phenomenon, the water bottle floating. As you can see, a water bottle will float in water because the point force that the water is putting on the water bottle is greater than the force of gravity on the water bottle, henceforth it's floating. Also notice how the density of the liquid is more of a water bottle, and that's also why it floats. So today we're gonna ask the question, can we build a water bottle boat that'll support a human? We're gonna look at the physics behind the water bottle floating. So as we saw from the previous example, the water bottle was floating in the water. Now, if we draw on the forces, the buoyant force is going to be greater than the force of gravity because it's floating so high in the water. If it's barely floating, force of gravity and force of buoyancy is going to be exactly the same. So that will be more of when the water bottle is sinking down and it's barely floating. So now what we're going to do is we're going to take the density, which is equal to mass over volume of both these objects, and we're going to solve for how much can this water bottle hold. So the density of water is going to be 1,000 kilograms per 1 meter cubed. What we know is the mass of this water bottle, which we weighed to be 8.41 grams and 16 fluid ounces. And 8.41 grams is equal to 0.00841 kilograms, all over 0.000473 meters cubed. That's the density of the water bottle, and obviously we have the density of the fresh water that it's in. And so now we're going to get a common denominator for the water. So we're just going to set up a proportion to match this volume. So when we do this, this x is going to be equal to 0.473 kilograms per 16 fluid ounces of volume. So now that we have this and we have our density for the water bottle, now what we're going to do is we're going to go back to the basic. If the density, we'll say the water bottle is less than the density of water, it will float. It's kind of the same thing with the buoyancy forces here. So what we're going to do is we're going to do 0.473 kilograms minus this 0.00841 kilograms all over this unit. And so when you get that, we'll just wipe this out because we've already converted these. And so that's going to be 0.46459 kilograms. And now we're going to multiply this by 2.2 because 2.2 pounds are 1 kilogram. And that's going to be equal to 1.022 pounds. So one 16-fluid ounce water bottle will support 1 pound. And so with that, we can measure ourselves and know how much water bottles we need beneath us to support our weight. All right, so step one in the boat making process, you need to process all of your water bottles. So what I like to look for, is there any extra water that'll weigh the bottle down? If there's not, like this one, then you go right to the cap. Does the cap fit on? Is it the right cap? And then what I would like to do for this project is rip off all these labels because we don't want them tearing off in the water. And so when you've got a lot of these processed, it'll look a lot like that. Clear bottles. Alright, so my choice of adhesive for this project will be a 100% silicone caulking by GE. Now the reason I chose 100% silicone is because it's watertight. Alright, so the next step in the boat making process is you gotta use your adhesive to put onto the bottle. So what we're gonna do is we're just gonna put a little, basically quarter inch dab at the top and the bottom. And then after you do that, you're gonna take your other bottle and you're gonna seal them together. And after they dry, it should look a lot like this. All right, so now for the assembly part of the boat, we're gonna take a little bit of caulking and put it across each of these and assemble it to another row.
No, seniors are 65 and older. 55 and older. No, yeah. No, you go to like Game City in Marcello. I don't know if now you're playing with the time or not. The age is going to Cedar Citizens Club.
All right, so now that we got that done. As you can see, all the blue is lined up in a row. And now we can assemble it to another row. And after that dries, it'll look a lot like this. Alright, the reason we put the shrink wrap on is to kind of act as an exoskeleton and give it some support so that the bottles don't go floating out when we get on and get off. So at the conclusion of our experiment, the boat did float, but as we look at it, you know, these are kind of torn off and broken everything. Our biggest takeaway, the silicone worked for the most part. We had to go through weeds to get through just to get to the lake part, so it kind of got torn up there. And then getting on and getting off, trying to distribute your weight is probably the biggest factor. Oh, and the shrink wrap is very cheap.
Yeah, the biggest problem when you're in the water is all your weight is centered in the middle of it. So in the middle kind of sinks lower. So then if you can't really move a whole lot, because the more you move, the more the bottles start to shift. So if I would have been moving while on the water, it all could have just fallen apart.
But as you can see, like all the stuff in the middle where all the weight was, torn apart, but on the outsides, like everything is still intact as it is.
The biggest part is just distributing your weight evenly.
Yeah, and some of the bottles on the outside were just loose. They were just in there with the shrink wrap. They weren't even glued together.
Good. Buoyant force.
We'll call that an AP Physics project.